everyone, and welcome back. For today's video, it is about the ABH Anastasia Beverly Hills Subculture Eyeshadow Palette. Now, moving forward, I'm just going to say ABH. I do plan on purchasing the Subculture Palette. I do have to wait a little bit before the Pro Artistry discount program is actually open for me to purchase the palette at a discount. However, just because I don't have the Subculture palette like right now in my hands, it doesn't mean that I don't have those colors probably already in my either ABH collection or in other eyeshadow palettes or just as singles. So what I did is I made some notes here. It's a lot of notes. And I pulled out all of my existing ABH palettes, and I was going through all the colors, trying to find shades that would match up to, okay, if I had the Subculture palette right now, I opened it up, what would be the color combination I would pick? Now, I love color. I like neutrals too, but I am a lover of color when it comes to the face. So the first initial combination that I want to try out when I get the palette is I want to do the green and yellows. And then after that, I'll play around with the blues, but I really am drawn to green and yellow. If I'm going to do a look from the Subculture palette that focuses on the greens and the yellows, I'm first going to look for a shade that is closely resembling to Dawn. I want to find something that is going to be close to Destiny, Untamed, and Edge. So those were the four shades that I was looking for. I am going by swatches and from looking at other reviews from individuals that had already received the palette from PR. So trying to kind of pinpoint the shades and the undertones, frankly, unless I have the palette myself, then I can really drill it down and find something very close. So it was kind of difficult because sometimes it might look a little bit yellow, or this shade might look a little bit orange. When I'm looking at the shade Dawn, I first initially wrote down that it's a matte yellow. But then on some people, it looked like it was like it had orange in it. So for Dawn, I ended up using Soft Peach, which is in the World Traveler palette. Next comes Destiny. That is a matte shade and it looks like an army green shade to me. I couldn't find any matte green shade in any of the ABH palette. I would say the closest shade as far as for Destiny is in the Master Mario palette, the Bronx shade, but the Bronx is actually a satin finish, so I wasn't going to go ahead and use that shade in my crease. So I actually pulled in a green from another makeup line. Next, let's look at Untamed. Now, Untamed, in my actual Instagram photograph of the actual palette, Untamed looks like another army green, but it looks like it has some blue in it, like a bluish green shade, but in a matte formula. But then I'm figuring if it's a bluish green, it's going to also mimic Axis, which is actually like a teal shade as well. So it was just throwing me off. I just kind of said, it looks like almost like a lighter version of Axis. I can't really tell if it's army green or not. So I'm just gonna go with the fact that it's just another dark green color. And again, once Subculture is in my hand, then I can go ahead and make that decision. So again, this is another color where I feel I had to pull in another brand's dark green to complete that look. Last we have is Edge. Now, Edge is a matte yellow. I can't tell from the swatches if it is a very deep, rich yellow. I also can't tell really the intensity of that particular yellow, the undertone, because again, I need it in the house. I need it in my hands to play with. So based on that, the yellow that I'm going to use is in the Artist palette, and that is the shade, I believe this is pronounced Fresh or Resh. It's right down there. So that's the shade that I use. How I like to apply color on the eyelid is I like to build it up in shades, but within the same color family. So you'll kind of notice that as I start to do more tutorials for the channel, I like to use between two to almost three, what I call transition shades, that will create that gradual effect. Now, I'm stating the term transition because to me, those shades, the two or three shades within that color family, is helping the next dark color that comes in to gradually transition or gradually fade into that shade. So it makes it quite cohesive. You might look at the top lid and think, you know, this is quite bold, the green and the yellow. So that's why what I did for the lower lash line is kind of toned it down a little bit. So let's say you're working in a professional or corporate environment. You can use the neutral tones that are in the palette, and you can also pull in the neutral tones from the Modern Renaissance palette, so its sister palette or its day palette. You can pull in those light tones. There is the light brown, there is a taupe shade, and then you can work that in with fudge, which is also in the Subculture palette, and you can apply that to your lower lash line. That can help tone down the brightness that you have on your lid. Now, I love red, so I use the red that is also in the Modern Renaissance palette, but I deepened it up with another red. You don't have to do that. So you can start with those neutrals to kind of help tone down that colorful shade, that bold brightness that might be able to help you kind of embrace that color. You also can incorporate the neutrals in with maybe just one bold color. So let's say you were interested in the yellow or the green or the blue that's in the Subculture palette. Take one bold color and then use neutrals for everything else. So try that first on your eye. Get a little bit comfortable to see a bright yellow, a bright green, a dark, deep, rich blue, or a jade blue that's in the palette. Kind of get used to that, but then pair it with a neutral color as well, like the fudge or some other neutrals that are in the Modern Renaissance. You'll see that once you start adding either just one bold color, one colorful shade, or trying to pair it two bold colorful shades with a neutral, and you actually start getting used to seeing it on your eyes. Same thing if you maybe want to try it with lipstick or you want to try it with blush. Once you start seeing that on your face, you'll start to condition your brain to get used to it, and you might like it, you never know. And now, time for the demonstration. My lid is primed with a semi-white base. I'm gonna go in now with the shade Fresh. That is gonna serve as my all over the eyelid, outer lid, as well as in the crease shade. This brush is fluffy enough but dense to kind of disperse the color throughout. Now I'm going to take the neon yellow shade from the Melt Radioactive Stack, and I'm working it into my crease to not only deepen Fresh up, but when I use a smaller brush, I'm actually intensifying the color as well and work that within my crease. Now, because I don't have a shade that I felt was similar to Dawn in the Subculture palette, I'm using the Soft Peach from the World Traveler palette. I'm gonna work that as my brow bone highlight, as well as just soften any of the edges from the yellow that's in the inner eye portion. Now I'm gonna take the Lime Green shade in the Radioactive Stack. Lime green is going to act as that transition shade for the dark green that I'm going to apply next. So the lime green, because it shares similar colors with the green and the yellow, and it actually will also give off that hint of blue in the eye and in the crease, I'm going to use that as that middle shade. So I'm working that into the crease and focusing it also on the outer lid. See how you can see the hint of green kind of poking out, especially on the outer edge of the lid. Now I'm going to go in with the dark matte green. This is from the brand Feather River Body in the shade Lost, one of my favorite shows when that show first came out. I love it. So now I'm blending that into my crease and also on my outer lid. I'm not going to use a shade on the actual lid itself, meaning like a shiny shade or metallic. So I really need the mattes to stand out. Just using green and using the yellow as that bold look. Blend in that dark green until it starts to really diffuse in color. Here I'm just using a blending brush with no color to soften out the lines. So I want the tear duct to be nice and shiny and bright since there's nothing on the inner lid. So I'm first applying Benefit's What's Up, and then I'm going to put the metallic Golden Dawn on top of it. The Benefit product first acts as a base to intensify whatever powder you put on top, and it also helps that powder last longer. Now for the lower lash line, I'm going to pull in the Modern Renaissance palette. Again, building up in color. So let's first start with burnt orange, that tan shade, to just work and blow out on the lower lash line. Then I'm gonna go to the top row of that palette and pull in the lilac shade, again, to merge in with that tan shade, because this will serve as that shade to transition into the dark matte red that I'm gonna be applying on next. Here I'm going to pull in a dark red Enigma from the Dark Matter stack, and that again is just further emphasizing and further building up that red pigment. Remember, do not be afraid of color. Embrace it and it will embrace you. Have a wonderful day or evening. Thank you so much for watching. I do appreciate it. And as always, I will see you all in the next video. Bye.